much for stopping by. This is Deeptima, and if you have seen the last two videos that I did on Navratri, I really hope you are enjoying it, and I'm still really hoping that I'm able to post all 9 looks. So today's color is green. Now I thought, like, the first thought that came to my mind was a green smoky look, but then I was like, not all greens are same, and I want you guys to be able to create this look, and not everyone is comfortable with green eyeshadows. So I thought, let's do something which is easy and which anyone or everyone can carry off despite their age. So I was on Pinterest and I saw this really beautiful bronzy look with a hint of color on the lower lash line. Whenever I want to, you know, jazz up, not exactly jazz up, but whenever I want to add color to my look, I go in for a colored liner, or I add the color on the lower lashes or in the inner corners. So this is what we are going to do in this video. I look really tired today because I have been running on very less sleep for the past 2 days, and I'm like really puffy right now. So guys, let's get started with this video. So first, as always, I always begin with my eyebrows. So today I am going to use Sugar's It's Arch Arrival Brow Definer Pencil in Taupe Tombe. Because I'm using this after a really long time, I think the product has dried out a bit. I would be using a concealer today. I am using MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NC25, and this is like really heavy concealer, and heavy in the sense it does have good coverage, as well as it is really good to hide pigmentation and discoloration, and it sets really fast. So the only problem I have with this is I can't control the amount I take out of the pump, because I'm always left with an extra product, with some extra product. So I feel I waste a lot of product when I use it, because you don't need a lot of it, and I always have to wipe off the extra. So I'm using Sugar's All Set All Day. It's All Set to Go setting powder, and I think it was open. I have the powder all over my dress now. So just setting my lids with the translucent powder. So for today's video, I really wanted to use this 1 million palette from Makeup Revolution. I haven't used it a lot, and I really wanted to use it on camera to show you guys the pigmentation. You can always use any other palette that you have with similar shades, and if you have this palette, then you can use the exact same shade that I'm using. So first I'm taking a nice fluffy brush, and I would be using this matte color, which is not exactly matte, but this will work as a good crease color. So this color is going to go in my crease and slightly above it, because this is my transitioning color. This color will help me blend the eyeshadows on the lid and above my crease and on my crease. Like, any color that I apply after this would be easily blendable because of this transition color. Next, I'm using Yishi's Doomed Crease Brush. I'm gonna use this color right here, which is a good brown color. This will go in my crease and in the outer corner. Next, I am going to use this bronzy color, because such colors go really well with Indian outfits and they complement most colors. So we are going to use this color. Let me swatch and show it to you. This is a very beautiful bronzy color. It also has some gold reflex, so it looks really pretty. Next, I'm gonna use this Maybelline Color Tattoo. I am not sure if these are still available, but this is a perfect match to the dress that I'm wearing. You can use any shade that matches your dress, and if you're not too much into matching, you can go in with your favorite color, like any favorite color of yours. next I'm taking the Jaclyn Hill palette and I'm gonna use the shade called Jade just to put it on top of this color tattoo. And Jade is this color right here. Today I'm going to try and use this Revlon Color Stay Exactify Liner. I am not a huge fan of it because of the price point, and also I tried it at launch and I wasn't very I wasn't very happy with the applicator. So let's see if I can draw a good liner out of it. So I applied some false eyelashes. These are from a brand called Henna Henna Beauty and these are in the style Shizza. So next I'm applying this Lakme Absolute, This is Lakme Absolute Precise Eye Artist Liner. This is in the shade Emerald Green and I am applying it in my waterline. Next, I'm gonna use the same palette and I will be using this golden color right here. Okay, right here, this golden color, because no makeup, like no Indian festive makeup is complete without golden, because you always have golden either in jewelry or in our outfit. So just looking for a tiny brush for this and I'm gonna use, I can't find my brushes today. Now it is looking festive, so just gonna do the same exact thing on the other side. Today I had a really bad luck with my eyeliner. One liner, the Faces one completely dried out and the Revlon one, I'm not a huge fan of it. It didn't really help me in applying the liner, like it just made applying liner a nightmare. So ignore the liner, I'm not very happy with it today. So let's proceed with the face makeup, which is gonna be very easy and very simple, something that I love to do when I am in a hurry. So usually I use my fingers for the application, but you can see I have so much product everywhere. So I'm gonna use a sponge today. So what I like to do is I like to use any illuminating primer or any illuminating face cream or serum, anything that you apply on your face. So I'm gonna take my Hydra Pro Glow. I love this product because this gives hydration and I mix it with the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer. Now this is really dry to be used on its own. So I use these two combination. This has hyaluronic acid, so it provides me hydration and this just mattifies everything. So I'm not too dewy when I use this combination and I'm not too dry. So I take a good pump, like good one pump of the Hydra Pro Glow and a tiny, like if I think half pump would be perfect. So yep, just a little bit of this. I need something to mix them together. Yep, this is good. So this is also like your DIY BB cream with a little coverage. Now next, because I have this mark on my face, if you don't have any marks or dark circles, you can skip this step. But I am not blessed with a flawless skin. Like, it's not that bad, but still sometimes when I am running on low sleep, I need a little more help with makeup. Because I'm keeping everything like lightweight on the face, I'm gonna use the Fit Me concealer. Now, you can use any other concealer that you require to hide those under eye circles. But because I have color corrected, I think this would be good for today. So I am quite happy with this much coverage. Next, I'm gonna use this Makeup Obsession banana powder, pressed banana powder, and I'm gonna set my under eyes with this. And this is also a really good inexpensive setting powder. It has a yellow tone, so it kind of highlights, like just lifts up the darkness, but I don't use too much of it because it can make the under eyes slightly dry. For contouring, I'm gonna use the Maybelline Fit Me. This is the Fit Me? No, this is Maybelline V-Shape Contour Face Contour Stick. So you can see I really love this product. I just have a tiny bit remaining there. So just gonna contour my face. Now, because I don't have a lot of foundation, I still have that little bit definition, but you can see I have a fuller face. I have a chubby face. So I really need that contouring. So just gonna contour on my regular places. And whenever I want a soft contour, I use this Maybelline V-Shape Face. I can never say its name. It's V-Shape Duo Stick. I never remember the names. So I use it for a very soft contour. When I want like really intense contour, I like to layer my contour, I like to layer this with a powder product to have a very nice chiseled face. I absolutely love the Hoola Light Bronzing Powder. Now this is really good if you have fair complexion, because this is lighter than Hoola Bronzer. I'm using Wise She Brush. This is a very soft, very fluffy brush. So I'm just applying it because I don't want a precise application. I just want to have a good color on my face. So I'm using it with this brush, because this brush just distributes it nicely and you don't get streaks and you don't get harsh edges. So it kind of blends everything together. I like this brush, like really soft brush. Next, I'm gonna apply some blush because I've already used so many powder products. I don't want my face to look really dry and patchy. I'm gonna go in with a cream blush. This is from Faces Canada. This is the All Time Pro Blendfinity Stick. This is in Sweet Apricot. I really like this. And how I like to use it is I like to just warm it up on the back of my hand like that. Smile, and I hope you can see it on camera. It is such a beautiful color. So the face makeup is almost done, guys. For my lips, I want to stick to this color theme which I have on my lids. And for that, I think this is a very good match. These are NYX Liquid Suede Metallic Matte Liquid Lipsticks. This one is in the shade Mauve Mist. I have tried it on. It looks really pretty. So I'm gonna put this on my lips now. I think this lipstick is really going well with the makeup look. So let me put on my earrings and I'll be right back. For this look, I have skipped highlighter, but you can still see my face looks kind of well lit because I wanted the attention to be on the eyes. And as you saw, I didn't play a lot with my face except a little contouring and blush, which was mandatory to get some definition back on my face. So this completes our look, guys. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. I had fun creating it as always. If you like the eye and lip combination, let me know in the comment section. I would also like to know what lip color you would have paired this eye makeup with, because I'm really curious to know what you think, like what you would have worn with this eye makeup. Initially, I wasn't very sure about the lip and eye combination, but to be very honest, I am really liking it. I am really liking the eyes and lip combination. Yes, so this is it, guys. Make sure before you leave my page, before you leave or skip this video, make sure you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Like this video if you enjoyed watching me, and you can even share it with your friends. So I will see you guys very, very soon in the next video. Till then, take care. Lots of love, hugs and kisses to you all. And see you very soon. Bye.